Moji roditelji su išli na posao i vraćali se nasmijani.
The textile sector was very prominent in socialist Yugoslavia. Since the 1950s, textile factories were built across the whole Yugoslav Federation, employing thousands of workers, particularly women. The industry flourished in the 70s and in the 80s in various Yugoslav republics. Textile work came to stand for women's new role on the labor market. Yugoslav fashion, on the other hand, was part of the construction of the socialist new woman, able to access urban modernity through consumer culture. At times, textile workers themselves became fashionable. In 1985, a fictionalized television series was set in the Sana textile factory in Bosanski Novi, western Bosnia. The program was called Priče iz fabrike. It portrayed the everyday life of factory workers and of the factory director, who was the son of one of the female workers. Ordinary workers, interviewed by the factory newspaper, were especially fond of this program, because it celebrated their work and contribution to the success of the factory. In the textile factory's newspaper of that time, one could read tales of hard work and sacrifice. It is also obvious that female textile workers took an active part in the life of the factory, and that their social status in society was protected in many ways. Job security was guaranteed, and they had access to free healthcare, kindergartens, subsidized meals, and paid holidays. Even if these services were not always of the highest standard, the factory functioned as an extended social community and welfare provider, particularly in peripheral towns.
A znaš kakav je bio taj park? Bilo je labudovje, bilo je patke, bilo je park sa zelenilo trava, drveće, pa ptice, pa šatke.
Since the early 50s, the town of Štip hosted a huge textile complex named Makedonka. The number of workers in Makedonka went from 3,500 in the mid-60s up to 6,400 in the late 80s. The complex included a restaurant, discount stores, childcare facilities, and a library. The factory also provided housing for its workers and holiday facilities at subsidized prices. Today, after a failed attempt of privatization and subsequent bankruptcy, the Makedonka complex is a wasteland, with only the warehouse selling meters of cloth, tools, rubber, and bolts. But what happened to the Makedonka workers? Where have all its workers gone? While many textile workers in post-Yugoslav states lost their jobs as a result of many factory closures, today in Macedonia the privatized textile industry employs approximately 40,000 workers. Working conditions, however, have deteriorated in the last 20 years. Local factories are mainly producing garments for Western companies, on whose orders they depend. Overtime work is common, and wages are very low. The nationwide minimum wage for textile workers in Macedonia is around 100 euros per month. Today, textile workers tell a tale of precarity, diminished social security, and struggle for survival through extended family networks.
Ako sam ja tada mogla da sa dve plate od Makedonka da mogu da iščuvam dve čerke i da imam dva stana i da mogu da idem na godišnji odmor, sada ne mogu.
At the entrance of the Makedonka warehouse, the picture of Tito still stands as a reminder of better times.
Kod nas se kaže ovako. Imali su ljudi esnaf, poštovanje, u kući i napolju. Tako da kad te neko vidi, vidi u tebe čovjek. Sad ne vidiš čovjeka, sad vidiš vuka.